can't even remember the running order. I'm going to presume the EP begins with a song called Not Your Summer. That was a song written in lockdown in Dublin. It was one of those ones where we had been filming some live stream gigs for Christmas, and I ended up back in my like little bedroom studio, and all I had was a nylon guitar that I treated myself to for Christmas. And I said I was gonna just try and simplify the process and go back to the basics of just an acoustic guitar and songwriting.
I love this song. As soon as we started jamming this kind of, it seemed quite jangly, and it kind of started to remind us a lot of The Replacements and The Smiths and R.E.M. and a lot of like the kind of jangled guitar stuff that we really like.
It was scary experience recording this because me and Craig did the drum recording and writing by ourselves, and we went into the studio really not knowing how it was going to turn out, and we were really happy with the kind of sounds we got in the end. It's not something we thought it was going to go down that route, but I think when we started to hear it all together, it made sense.
A lot of my favorite music ever comes from that kind of 60s wall of sound, kind of Phil Spector, Wrecking Crew era of like pop songs. And that became more of a reference as we kind of delved deeper into Not Your Summer. And one of my favorite bass players of all time is Carole Kaye from The Wrecking Crew. So I started to think kind of more in that style. And that's where the kind of bouncy bass line came from.
For me on the guitar, we really wanted to retain that sort of woodiness of the nylon playing the riff and kind of have it sounding almost really young and naive and childlike almost. So I'm usually big amp, big loud electric guitar. So the track on nylon acoustic guitar was cool. It's also probably got my favorite lyric on the EP. Don't you forgive, don't you be naive. Confused in love with the sunny day, it took a while to walk away. It's probably one of my favorite lyrics that Craig has ever written.
I've always been very reluctant to tell people exactly what a song means or exactly what it's about to us, because I think a lot of the beauty is in the mystery, not just with music, across any kind of art in general. But I think I can say with safety that I can tell you what the song is not about.
It's not a song about COVID or like the pandemic, but it kind of is as well in a way, because it was just like, I don't know, the lockdowns were just so intense. And there's a lyric, it's like, I needed some time away from myself and nobody could get that. And then the chorus came, thinking about lives that aren't being lived at the moment.
But if that's how you feel about the song, if that's what you bring to it, then what do I know? Who am I to tell you how to feel?
Lyrically and musically, the centerpiece for the EP, because musically wise, a lot of the songs when we kind of first started putting them together was just Craig with a beat up nylon and him singing over that. And we sort of fleshed it out from there, like, and that was kind of the first one that sounded really good with nylon. Lyrically and thematically, it just occupies that weird, like happy but sad kind of space. I think all of the songs on the EP really have sort of upbeat, but thematically kind of like more of a downer maybe than most of our stuff. And I just feel like it's sort of the linchpin of the whole EP.
That's my two cents on Not Your Summer.